Haifa is different for many reasons, but I can tell you two reasons that are really true all over the history of the city. First of all, Moses wasn't here, Jesus wasn't here, and Muhammad wasn't here. And it means that there are no any religious demands on any part of the city, on the land of the city, and it's very important. And the other thing is that economical and social interests or reasons came over national interest, because people in Haifa, whether they are Jews or Arabs, or even before the establishment of the State of Israel in 1948, all the people had one main reason. They wanted to find a place to live, to work, to educate, and to receive services that every human being has a right of. And they found it in Haifa. And together they worked side by side to make this city what it is today. The Holiday of the Holidays was created 18 years ago. And the main idea was that at the same time, on December, Jews, Muslims, and Christians celebrate their holidays, Hanukkah, Christmas, and Ramadan. And the idea was to bring all the people together to Beit HaGefen, to Wadi Nisnas, to the city of Haifa, and really celebrate those holidays together. It started in a very small scale. It was a week, and people arrived and participate in different events. Artists displayed their art in the neighborhood. And it was like this for a few years. But then, at the year 2000, something happened that it became the turning point of the festival. At that year, the second Intifada started on October. And all over Israel, there were demonstrations and the protests of the Arab citizens. And unfortunately, certain young Arabs died during those demonstrations. In Haifa, there was a demonstration as well, but the mayor of Haifa at that time, Mr. Amram Mitzna, came and talked with the people and asked them to keep the demonstration quiet. They have the right to demonstrate, to protest, to say whatever they feel, but not to escalate to violence. And it was as he asked. But even though the atmosphere in the city was a little bit heavy, and we felt that people didn't arrive to the neighborhood or didn't arrive to places where there were Arabs. And because the holiday of the holidays was supposed to start on December, Beit HaGefen, together with the municipality of Haifa, took a decision to make two things, to make things maybe better or more calm. First of all the religious leaders were invited to come to Beit HaGefen to meet, to talk about the situation. And they came out with a declaration calling the people to maintain tolerance, respect, understanding, all the things that the city is known for. And the other thing, all the artists that participate in the festival were invited to the Wadi Nisnas neighborhood. The people that live there, that most of them are Arabs, were asked to open their houses and to bring out to the street, to the main street of the neighborhood, food and sweets. And the street was full of tables and chairs and, of course, people. And really, people realized that the things maybe change a little bit. Something bad has happened, but they are given a second chance to restore the good relationship that they used to have before October, and they came back again on December. And from that point on, I believe that the festival became a real tradition, not just in Haifa, but all over Israel. And it became a national festival in which thousands and thousands of people from all over the country, and not just from Israel, arrive and participate in all the events, programs, projects that we offer during the festival.